Hi, my name is May Beaubrun and I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with Brett DiNovi and Associates. In this video, I'll be discussing training staff and client progress via telehealth. This video will go over the BACB 5th edition tasks area B14, define and provide examples of verbal operants. In the Barkaia et al. Article, remote consultation was utilized to coach 3 ABA therapists at varying levels of education and training. The dependent variable of the study were to increase correct command sequences, that's direct commands, repetition of commands, and error correction, and positive consequences, descriptive and non-descriptive praise, positive touch, and verbal imitation of the therapist, and also improve ECHOIC and MAN repertoires of 3 children with autism receiving early intervention services. During initial therapist training, telehealth coaching was provided to the therapists through spoken and written descriptions of the ECHOIC and MAN operants. The coach provided the ABA therapist with practice opportunities to teach the difference between target responses, so they correctly identified verbal operants and procedures like correct commands, positive consequences, etc. During coaching sessions, the consultant provided reminders of the importance of contingencies of positive consequences and command sequences, and used behavior-specific praise when the therapist delivered positive consequences and command sequences appropriately. The coach provided prompts to the therapist when they missed an opportunity to use positive consequences or command sequences. Prompts faded as coaching sessions continued. As a result, ABA therapists demonstrated improvements in both correct command sequences and positive consequences, and the children's ECHOIC and MAN repertoires improved. So how does this translate to our practice? So first of all, schedule times before and after the session to discuss the intervention procedures with the clinical team. This includes caregivers. Second, prioritize which goals to implement and make that the focus until the skill is acquired. In this study, the focus was just on ECHOICs and MANs, allowing ample opportunities to practice and receive feedback. This will also limit the dialogue during coaching sessions so that the clinician can remain client-focused. And thirdly, track and monitor the performance of the client as well as the caregiver or whoever's implementing the intervention. Thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and to disseminate the science, share this video. Mm-hmm.